like Alice was talking, the advantages of the tip, and I was also talking about the disadvantages of the tip. So I already explained the principle of tip, and in the bag there is no epithelium. Actually, the tip technique has been evolving. This is what you see here is the original description in 1994. How the incision was, how the urethropit was very narrow, how the incision was made, and how it was closed. This is the presentation of Warren when we did the webinar in March this year. You see how wide we opened the urethral plate and how he does not incise to the very tip, and he actually has no, it's completely different than what he described. If you take such a wide urethral plate, why on earth do you have to incise it? First was for every case, now it's only for distal, and then it's only for distal if there's no protein. To accommodate it, it's only when you don't need to incise it. This is the classic appeal. This is a famous paper, 2014, and he considers this as a successful tip repair. You see how the meatus is going as far down as the coronal sulcus. This is how patients come to me after tip and ask, is this how it should look like? No, of course not. This is how it should look like. You see the involvement. Tish, you have a completely epithelized urethra. Hinging by Rich and Patel, he used a material but incised it at the dose. The non-epithelial urethra is a very nice tip. With a tip, is almost half or more without any epithelium. With this slam, it's completely epithelized like a tear, but from different tissues. I showed you the list. Here you see examples. Very beautiful looking, but non-functioning slit-like meatus. When you incise it, you find the incised urethra plate has healed with a linear scar, and the new urethra is less than 5 millimeters. When you compare it to the proximal, it's about 2 centimeters, 4 times more. Remember, this is intact, so each side is 1 centimeter, so the urethra itself is 2 centimeters.
It's like a reticulum.
Yeah. And here, it's only half centimeter. Around catheter size 14 at the end of the procedure. And when you press on the bladder, you see how nice beautiful skin and how nice looking he is after the slam. Another child, he has a beautiful slit-like meatus, but he has difficulty. You think that the meatus is wide and everything is perfect. But when you look carefully, you see that the opening is very narrow. Again, this is the newer version of the tip, where you don't close the glands to the tip, but you leave it down to avoid smoothing, and this is what you end up with. Looks nice, but the opening is actually narrow. So you incise it, you see how the urethra is very narrow here, and because it was edematous, we had to leave everything until it heals completely, and then we repair it. This patient I showed you before, and where I had to get everything until it heals, no problem. One thing you have to remember, you are doing serving the child so that he can use his organ for the next 18 years, not 70. So take as much stages as you want. Who cares? final outcome. What I tell the parents, because I don't throw the foreskin at the same time. I tell them, when you're doing the research again, like building a house, it's no advantage that you build four floors in one day. You make the ground or the basis, wait until it heals, be proper, build the first floor, wait until you make sure it's proper, build the second, no problem. You have to do the job properly, and you have to remember that he's supposed to use it for 20, for 18 years. This is the patients I showed before. This is the fistula, how we see it. Again, very narrow with a deep groove. I showed this before. Wound dehiscence. Diverticula, we showed all this. We showed all this. We show this. So let's have an idea of how the tip incision heals. When you do internal urethrotomy, this was done experimental study on canine, and you see how the internal urethrotomy, because when you are doing the tip, it's just like you are doing internal urethrotomy. And you see how it heals with extensive fibrosis and collagen accumulation. This is a study done by Yasetan on rabbits, where he marked part of the urethra, incised it, measured it at about 1 centimeter, made the urethral passage, waited until it healed, and we didn't really gain more than 1 or 2 millimeter by the size of the urethral glands. This is like healing with primary intention and secondary intention. Those who got the fellowship would know healing with secondary intention, you have extensive inflammation, extensive contraction, extensive accumulation of collagen fibers. The urethra paint is different than normal urethra. This is a very interesting study done by a Sudanese surgeon working in Qatar. His name is Tariq Abbas. There was a child, they did a tip repair, went well for 3-4 years, and then came with the stenosis. They did frequent dilatation, it did not help. And then they had to excise, because this is very rare to do, to excise the healed urethra plate after 4 or 5 years. And they could show extensive collagen and fibrosis at the area where the incision of the urethra plate was done. I did a very interesting experience or study. We have a patient with perineal hypersphenias, and he had severe penis scrotal transposition. You see, the scrotal skin is encroaching. We did see the procedure, but we left the meatus. But if we left it like this, then we don't have enough urethral plate, and we'll be using the scrotal skin. So what we did is we incised. This was about 5 millimeter, the rest of the urethral plate. And we wanted to see if we incise the urethral plate, do we gain width of the urethral plate or not. This is healthy, this is near the meatus, not a very distant hand. So we incise this narrow urethral plate with the hope that it will widen, and then we can tubularize it and avoid having scrotal skin. So it was 5 millimeter here, we incised it, you see it here, and we became 10 millimeter after incision. We did the sigil, and we wanted to mimic exactly what you do with the tip. So we did leave it like this. We could tubularize it without making the risk for cross. In other words, we left the edges wide open. And we left these sutures for 10 days, which is exactly more than what you do in it. Now after 10 days, we removed these sutures, and then the charm came 4 months later to close the proximal discotomy. And this is just to revise, this is how it was before incision, about 5 millimeters. This is how it was when we incised it, became 10 centimeters. And this is how it looked like after 3 or 4 months, again, 4 or 5 millimeters. So incision of the urethra bleed, even when you put a catheter, does not heal, resulting in one urethra. At least in about 30%. Now, we find some people claiming the problem is not in the technique, the problem is in the surgeon doing the technique. So I'll share with you two American children who came to me in Germany. He had a tip procedure done in a very famous center in the States. And he was having regular dilatation every week for 5 years. Until the parents were fed up and then they came to him. And I opened everything. You see again, I widened it a plate, not more than 5 millimeters. We did a slam on him. You see the glandular bridge or wide about 5 millimeter, and at the end of the procedure. And it went very well. Another child, not American, went to the States, was operated on twice, but in a very famous center, and the poor family, every operation paid about $53,000 for every, so eventually they paid $106,000 without success. So in conclusion, the tip can be associated, this was presented while by online with Snodgrass and Nicole Bush watching and all the Americans. So tip can be associated with severe complications. The urethra bleed is less than 8 millimeters or hypoplastic. You may consider putting the dorsal in a graft. And please, please do not burn your bridges. Keep the foreskin. There is no magic in surgery. At the end of the day, if you are interested, I hope I got you interested, you can watch this free proximal hypospadias on the 12th of March next year. The second edition of the book is coming out soon. We finished it. It's in the hand of the publisher now, and hopefully it will come out maybe in February or so, and in other words, in about 3 or 4 months. 90% of it is new, and this is our aim at the end of hypospadias surgery, to make it easier for you. Thank you.